It's a long story and a grim one. Also, it has us, for the moment, pretty fairly beat. And when I say that, it means a lot. I'll confess immediately that the puzzle is a long way from being solved, at the same time assuring you that that reflects no dishonor on the police force. I'd be the last man to pretend that it's perfect. I know it too well, but it does attain a pitch of competence of which the laity have no conception. It's no use asking the man in the street what he thinks of the CID, for example. You might as well ask an idiot child what it thinks of the Greek alphabet. There's another thing to bear in mind, and that is that the police don't like mysteries. The public can't believe that. They think, if there isn't a mystery afoot, the police force is as restless as a kitten, going round trying to scrape up trouble. It's different for the public. Murders and such like make amusing and exciting reading, and provide an immediate topic of conversation. And the press gets a lot of free copy, and generally someone receives an offer to go on the halls for a few weeks until the general excitement has died down. I've met men who told me solemnly that the average constable would rather strike a criminal than put a year's pay on the Derby winner. They'll tell you it means promotion, kudos, publicity, all the rest of it. Don't believe all that trash. In the ideal state, there wouldn't be any crime. We should prevent it. The police realize that, if the rest of the world doesn't.
Then he asked me how long I'd been out of the country. I said 7 months, and Jeremy, in response to a questioning glance, said 2 years.
Then probably you won't have realized what's been going on for the last year or more. Unless you were a very assiduous and observant student of the daily papers, it's unlikely you would have noticed much anyway.